All right, set to go, Patrick Kane. And the Gatorade NHL puck control. So again, Keith, the players must complete three skills. Fastest time wins. First, you must control the puck through a series of these 10 pucks. And then the cone control, weaving through eight cones, and then we will finish it off at the three gates.
Yeah, just put a clinic on the first two parts of this event as you're describing it. He was going to work here, and here's the difficult part, trying to flip that puck up on your stick and calmly toss it through the hole. And Patrick Kane makes it look easy, like he always does. That's going to be very difficult to beat. Patrick Kane putting on an absolute clinic. And look at that smile on Patrick Kane's face. He knew that he had the potential to do what he just did. This is not easy, but look how calmly Patrick Kane maneuvers through the pucks and then goes to work with that puck on the end of his stick, easily flips it up and puts it through, and just a great demonstration of the skills that these players possess.
Kane's time, 4 seconds slower than the winning time by Johnny Gaudreau last year.
That's incredible, actually, isn't it?
Although Gaudreau told JR that Kane might be his toughest challenger.
I believe he's right, but keep an eye on this guy that's coming up next, Elias Pettersson, who has taken the league by storm and done a fabulous job putting the Vancouver Canucks back on the map.
So here comes Elias Pettersson, having trouble with one of the pucks, and now he lost the puck.
You can see the smile on his face there as he caught the first puck, and let's see as he goes back to work here. Does not get the restart, but we'll just jump in there and see if he can finish strong.
So that will certainly affect his time.
Yeah. I'm not great in math, but I know that's going to hurt.
I think he was looking for the do-over.
Yep. He was.
Now to the gates. New puck, a heated puck, which is easier to pick up with the stick.
Incredible. Look at some of the moves that he's making there. He's still putting on a good show. What a good sport. As Pettersson does a terrific job. Take a look at exactly where things went wrong for Pettersson here. Catches one puck early, and then right there he loses control, tries to regroup, and then knocked another one off.
Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Kenny. I'm with Patrick Kane. Patrick, I'm going to let you do a little play-by-play when Jeffrey Skinner of the Buffalo Sabres goes, but what's the hardest part of this competition?
The hardest part is coming out of these Gatorade bottles into this one and picking up the first puck, but I think this guy should be pretty good. You know, he might throw a little 10-2 in there for us because he's pretty good at that with his skates where he puts them together. So let's see what he's got.
What's your best Doc Emmerich invitation right now? Here goes Jeffrey Skinner. Come on, Patrick, step on it.
Can never live up to Doc. All right, let's see how he does. Got to get through those pucks clean, but he adjusted pretty well there. He's back in the game. This guy's got sick edges, so I wouldn't be surprised to get through these pretty quick. Doing a good job. This is a big tricky part right here. He's got the middle one, so he's got to pick it up. All right, picking it up. Here he goes. He might be able to beat this. He had me though. He had me. I think that was pretty good.
Thanks a lot, Kane. I really appreciate your time.
No problem.
Kenny.
Take a look at what Jeff Skinner was doing out there, right through the middle one there. And through the top easily, and then tried to rush it here after having a couple bumps in the road in the early part. Big smile on his face, and the player's having a good time as he watches his replay on the Arena Vision.
Trying to catch it on his stick, leading up to that third and final gate. Excellent job on play-by-play by Patrick Kane.
He's got a future, doesn't he?
I think he does.
Let's hope it's a mile away.
Yes. Here's Mark Scheifele of the Winnipeg Jets in his first All-Star game. What a player he is.
Incredible player, and a great feature on him in the pregame show. Just a very intelligent player that loves the game, watches it when he's not playing it. And you can see how the skills that Mark Scheifele possesses. A big guy like that making some great moves and just gets a little unlucky there as the puck got away from him.
You must put him through all three gates and then into the goal. Shifley finishes at 32.161.
We can take a look at the player trail here through the bottles. On the blue tracking right there. Goes well with his uniform. Great plays by Mark Shifley around. And the finish to this, he was right there. If he didn't lose that puck after getting through the second obstacle late, he would have had a chance to overtake the lead, but still a very respectable time.
Patrick Kane still in the lead with four skaters remaining. Here's Gabriel Landeskog of the Colorado Avalanche, has already scored a career-high 29 goals this season. His entire line is here in San Jose.
And does most of his work in front of the net using his size and strength. So great to see him demonstrate the skills that he possesses. He plays with two of the most skillful players in the NHL frequently. And you can see that Landeskog, no slouch, as he's done a terrific job getting to this point.
Now through the top gate. Lost the puck. One more. 33.425.
Pretty impressive by Gabriel Landeskog. And the first run caused him some issues. Patrick Kane in breaking it down on the last skater. Jeff Skinner mentioned just how difficult this part can be and how hard it can be when you're trying to get it through the lower one, which is surprising. The middle one he has no problem with as he fires that through and into the net. Here's another great smile there. His teammate Blake Wheeler and Mark Shifley having a laugh, and Landeskog doing his part to put on a good show.
Six-time All-Star Claude Giroux of the Philadelphia Flyers. Patrick Kane in the lead by 4 seconds. Giroux zigzagging his way through the cones,
making it look easy here, and outstanding set of hands. Let's see what he does in lifting this puck up. The low one there, the most difficult one, and he manages to get that through and retrieve it quickly. Pop it through the middle and then take that rolling puck and slam it through there. Another very good run this time. Claude Giroux just a second and a half away from Patrick Kane, as Patrick Kane's having a good chuckle about it. And here's Claude Giroux going through the bottles at real speed. Just transitions quickly over to grab the warm puck after he slides this out of the way. Takes the snow off the blade and goes to work getting through the final obstacles there. Good stuff from Claude Giroux.
You mentioned the lowest game is the toughest.
Yeah, and that's just coming from Patrick Kane. So that has come to fruition so far.
John Tavares of the Toronto Maple Leafs. 9 years with the New York Islanders. Tied for second in the league with 30 goals so far this season. Now to the gates.
Yep, and here's the big challenge. The top one has been the easiest for all the guys. The middle one proving to be a little difficult for John Tavares as he appeared to get it through, and then he makes easy work of getting it through the lower one, but can't get it to the net. Eventually tracks it, puts it in, and loses a couple valuable seconds there in retrieving that puck.
Patrick Kane still has the lead. Remember when JR spoke with Johnny Gaudreau, who is up next and last, he said the one guy that he thought could challenge him is Patrick Kane.
Yep, he is the guy to beat for Johnny Gaudreau right now. He'll go to work here and try to build on what's been an incredible year for Johnny Gaudreau and the Calgary Flames.
73 points, third of the National Hockey League. Calgary with the second best record, trailing only Tampa Bay. How about Johnny Gaudreau? It's his fifth season in the league, his fifth All-Star game.
Yeah, makes it look easy, doesn't he? You get a great display of all the skills that he worked on as a young boy, skating on the rink that his dad managed. Steve Gaudreau doing a great job in bringing up a great gentleman, and Johnny Gaudreau.
Johnny's winning time last year, 24.65. Must beat Patrick Kane, 28.611, and he will!
Is that incredible or what? I mean, imagine the pressure of trying to go up there through that obstacle course, get to the final three, and make easy work of it. Even bobbled the first attempt at going through the pucks, quickly retrieved it, and then put on a great demonstration of how to turn around and get it through these bottles efficiently. And then this part is just incredible. There's the tough one he talked about. Look how easy he makes that look. Kane also doing the same thing. And then Johnny Gaudreau taps one through. And there you can see the two superstars.
He beat Patrick Kane by a second and a half. Down to JR.
Johnny, you said before this started that Patrick Kane was going to be your biggest challenge. How nervous were you down there when you did this?
I was a little nervous at first. I lost the puck there first, but managed to get through the Gatorade bottles relatively quickly, and picked my head up, made sure I knew which one to go for first there.
What did you feel when you came to the towers here? Did you have a chance? Were you a little bit nervous when you were getting the puck up?
You know, I didn't even know how much time I was at or anything like that. I just tried not to mess up, and thankfully got each one through.
Tremendous job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The winner, back-to-back years, Johnny Gaudreau.